I'm Patty Fernandez, and I'm an art teacher. Visit my website at pattyfernandezartist.com. Okay, let's draw. Today's project is how to draw the swallows returning to Mission San Juan Capistrano. I'm going to take three fingers from the left and I'm going to put a dot. And from that dot, I'm going to draw straight line down, straight line over, straight line up, straight line connect. Right here on the left, I draw a straight line down. Come on the right, straight line down. At the bottom, straight line, straight line, straight line, straight line connect. And one more, straight line, straight line, straight line, up and connect. I take four fingers and I put a dot. And now I'm going to draw a straight line down, straight line over, straight line up, straight line connect. On the left, straight line down. On the right, straight line down, straight line over, and connect. One more, straight line, straight line, straight line over, up, connect. One more, straight line out, down, over, up, and connect. This sets up our foreground. What does that mean? This is the part that is going to be closest to the viewer of our drawing. I come way over here on the left and I'm going to draw a big curve line down, connect, leave a little bit of a space, draw another big curve line down, connect, one more off the page, big curve line down, off the page. We're still working on the foreground. Come down at the bottom and we're just going to draw little flat ovals all the way over to the edge. Keep going. Everybody's is going to look different. And this is because your foreground is setting up the bottom part of your drawing. I would suggest strongly, since there's a lot of drawing and a lot of overlaps and making sure that you get everything detailed out, you might want to do the drawing on session one, come back and do the coloring on session two. So you're going to bring these flat ovals all the way over from left to right, making sure that they all connect at the bottom. Okay? All right. So this is now our foreground. Next, we're going to come back up to this point, and starting over here on the bottom, we're going to draw another curve line, connect. Come on this side, curve line, connect. One more, curve line, connect. Now we're going to draw straight diagonal down, straight diagonal down, straight diagonal down, straight diagonal down, connect, straight diagonal down, connect. I come inside, this is now the inside part, and I'm going to start on the left and I'm going to draw a straight line, jump over, straight line, come down, and leave that line, straight line, floating. Right here on this point, I'm going to come in, and I'm going to draw a curve line over, down, connect. I'm going to put a straight line, connect. And I'm going to mimic that line on the inside. So I'm going to go straight line, curve line, connect. All right. Come back over here to the left and we're going to draw a straight line over, connect. Come down here and we're going to draw a curve line, leave it floating, jump over, curve line, leave it floating. Okay. Now, we're going to come in and fill in this space. Curve line, curve line, curve line, connect. Curve line down, curve line up, down, up, out, connect, curve line, curve line, curve line, curve line, connect. Now we come over to this space and we're going to go curve line, curve line, curve line, bring it down, curve line, connect, curve line, down, up, connect, curve line, up, down, connect, curve line, out, in, connect, curve line, curve line, curve line, curve line. Jump over one more time and we're going to go curve line, curve line, curve line, curve line. And now we're going to go curve line down, up, connect, curve line out, down, out, down, out, down, connect. Okay. Some of you, okay, let's come up here. I forgot my tile roof. Curve lines up, connect. Everybody's drawing is gonna look a little bit different because we all draw differently. This should all be curve lines, curve lines, curve lines, curve lines. All right. Somebody's gonna say, hey, where, let's connect these lines. Where are the swallows? They're right here. And you get to make bird curve line, curve line, curve line. You can fit as many as you want. You can fit them in. Curve line. One, two, three, four, five. I got five birds. Okay, let's see how. I hope this is it. Let's see how we're going to color this in. Okay, for this drawing, there is a lot of double coloring, triple coloring, but double coloring mostly. And I would do, like I said earlier, session one for drawing, session two for adding color. Okay, I'm going to add some blue-green. And this represents the inside part of the archways. Okay, it's as if you're looking inside the archways. So this is going to be blue-green. And that's basically just to break up the color that we're going to do in just a minute. So we're going to do some blue green across these top eaves. Okay, next I'm taking my regular brown and I'm just going to loop-de-loop the space in between. You all will do a way better job than me. I'm just putting the colors in the way I think. If you have a better idea for color, go for it. This is just an example of how I'm finishing my drawing. You can finish yours any which way you would like. But this is the inside eaves of the colonnade, it looks like, or the inside part of the mission. Okay, so you're going to do a lot of double coloring. This one, though, is pure brown. Okay, then I'm going to take, if you have them, multicultural crayons. We do light to dark, and I'm just going to draw some lines going across, following my rectangles to get a little bit of color on the inside part of my columns. If you don't have multicultural crayons, you can do this with your brown. It's basically using light to dark. So I'm putting some color in so that I get that double color look. These are archways also in the mid-ground. So I'm going to put those in. Okay. Then I come back with my brown. And I can loop-de-loop first so that I get rid of all that white. Now this drawing is going to be almost all colored in. Okay. So, like I said before, do session one for drawing, do session two for coloring. You might even want to do session three for coloring. Take your time. It's not a race. All right, now I come down to my columns, and I can loop-de-loop the color in, but I'm also going to add some dark brown lines to give it a little bit of texture. Now, when you look at the missions inside the walls, they look like they have exposed adobe. So you can leave some of it not colored in totally, but not all of it not colored in. Okay. Now I'm coming over and I'm adding some dark brown lines. And that's so that my eye follows the dark lines and gives it a little bit, like I said, more texture. Okay. All right, you can even add a little bit on these mid-brown archways. Okay. All right. Next, I took red violet and I colored in my tile. Now, some of you might want to do this red, that's fine, but I wanted to give it a little bit more of a color, so I took my red violet, colored in my tiles, then I went over it with my brown, just to give it a different tone, a different look, but still get color. Okay? Next, shrubbery. I'm going to take a yellow and do these plants, or this space. So I do a coat of yellow, go over it with some brown. So you get kind of a banana look. But again, we're two-toning, we're doing double coloring on some of the aspects, just to break up the color a little bit. Next, I'm going to use my regular green for my shrubberies, this space, these curved lines, hello, all the way over. Then I'm going to come in, and any spaces down here, I'm going to use my yellow green. These are all gardens, real beautiful. Okay. Last but not least, get your brown again, and we're going to color in our space down here at the bottom. Now, what I like to do is I literally take my crayon and just loop-de-loop it very dark in the space of the flat oval. Because again, that gives you a different look, gives your crayon a different look all the way over. You can also, now that I thought about it, you can also do this as a watercolor. You can do it with colored pencils, acrylics. Okay, so now that I've done the dark on my foreground, I come back in with my crayon and I do a loop-de-loop to fill it in. Kind of don't want anything to show except that. Now, because this is my drawing, I take a regular blue, and I'm going to fill in my archways with a blue straight line. This is totally my idea. If you want to color it in, go for it. As a matter of fact, you could put a fountain in if you wanted to. Don't forget this little space. Don't forget your archways. You could color in the whole thing differently. Add more people if you wanted to. Add a fountain. And add more swallows. Okay, let's see what this looks like all colored in. Okay, here are the swallows returning to San Juan Capistrano Mission. Okay, bye-bye.